You're watching 10 News. Back in 2002, most Australians had never heard of the terror group Jemaah Islamiyah. But after the Bali bombings, we became all too aware of its deadly plans.
Today, the bombers, the plotters and their backers have been killed or are in prison. Hugh Rimmington joins us now. A key figure in the hunt for the Bali terrorists says it's one of the best examples of police cooperation anywhere in the world.
Yes, Bill, the former Australian Federal Police Chief Mick Kelty has been reflecting on the last 10 years, just reminding us also that back in 2002 there was still a lot of tension between Australia and the Indonesians over what had happened in East Timor. There were a few resentments still in play, but it was the police cooperation that ensured that fundamentally the terrorists failed in the end on every single one of their goals.
Within hours of the Bali atrocity, Australian Federal Police Chief Mick Kelty was on the ground. He admits now he wasn't sure then the perpetrators would ever be caught.
Well, I have to be honest with you. I really didn't know how we were going to make sense of what had happened.
The blast site was so huge, key evidence was scattered for blocks around. But critically, Indonesia wanted our help.
As a model of cooperation, it's probably one of the best examples modern law enforcement has seen anywhere in the world.
We do believe it is the work of suicide bombers.
It was Indonesian police who made the first breakthrough, finding an obscure identifying mark in the Mitsubishi van used for the major bomb. That led them to this man, Amrozi. And he almost gleefully implicated half a dozen others, including his own brother, Mukhlis.
The ringleader is this man, Abu Bakr Bashir.
The so-called spiritual leader of Jemaah Islamiyah, Abu Bakr Bashir, was arrested, convicted, but later acquitted on appeal for any role in the Bali bomb. But today he's in jail anyway, imprisoned for 15 years over a terrorist training camp elsewhere in Indonesia. Almost all of the three dozen people directly connected with the Bali bomb are now either dead or in jail. Amrozi, Mukhlis and Imam Samudra were executed in 2008. Hambali, the Al-Qaeda connection, was caught in Thailand, transferred to Guantanamo Bay. He remains there to this day. The last of the major players, Umar Patek, was captured last year in Abbottabad, the same Pakistani city where Osama bin Laden, who gloated over the Bali attacks, was tracked down and killed a few weeks later. So, was justice delivered?
I'm imagining that families will never think that justice has been served.
But 10 years on, he says,
the judicial process worked. And to me, that's a rebuttal of any suggestion that the terrorists had won.
He does warn, however, no one can say it couldn't happen again.
Now, 10 years on, there are still many stories of that night that haven't been widely told. One group of Aussie mates was caught up in the Kuta bombings. What they did that night had become a quiet legend of courage and mateship. Emily Rice caught up with some of the heroes of that terrible night.
They look like just another bunch of Aussie mates holidaying in Bali, hamming it up for the camera.
I love surfing boy!
I love surfing boy!
But just after this footage was taken on October 12, 2002, the party turned to pure terror for these eight Perth teenagers. They were in the Sari Club when the second bomb went off.
Call it luck or, you know, someone's looking over us.
We're very, very fortunate and very thankful to this day.
10 years on, they are back in Bali to remember those who weren't so lucky.
We could have so easily been one of the names on the board.
We're here for each other, and then on the other hand, we're here to mourn the people that passed away and didn't make it home to their loved ones.
Five of them were awarded bravery medals for saving each other and strangers. Daniel Bone Smith carried two Japanese girls they were parting with earlier to safety, and a Balinese man they had just met helped get them all to hospital. They survived, but no one's heard from them since.
It's be amazing to see them, just to see that they're, still going all right.
While these men saved several lives, they're not too keen on being called heroes. They're just happy to be here and able to tell their story.
That's all it was, just a bunch of mates.
A decade later, the boys have become men.
10 years on, we've grown up a lot.
But their bond will never be broken. In Bali, Emily Rice, 10 News.
Now, fame comes to people in many ways. No one would want it to come to you in the way that it did to Peter Hughes. He survived that night, but only just becoming, I guess you'd say, probably the face of the disaster for many people back home.
Yeah, I think so. It's probably not the most comfortable, I guess, position to be in, but Yeah, I survived something. It was just the most tragic situation. I and many other people were involved in, especially the 88 Australians who didn't come home.
So the 10th anniversary tomorrow, what does that mean? How much has it been weighing on you?
Oh, a lot. This has been going on for 10 years, and I think this is my swan song. This is what I want to finish off with. This is how I believe this is how I want to leave Bali, leave the ceremonies and the anniversaries and all that behind me. I still, every year, will pay respects to the 88 Australians and obviously all the families that were involved. And, we're still a part of it. We're alive and we'll keep it alive till the day I die. So I want to give that support back to and want to make sure people in Australia don't forget.
How much does the support matter to people who've survived, they may be struggling?
Oh, plenty. They need all the support they can get. Let it be known that it did happen 10 years ago, but, we're still suffering. I'm still suffering inside, and, I mightn't show it on the outside, but I can tell you that if I'm doing it, a lot of the hundreds of people that were involved from Australia, and obviously the victims' families, it's just been separations and it's been suicides. There's been all sorts of stuff going on for the last 10 years, and this will keep going.
Well, Peter, I'm sure all Australia wishes you well and everyone else well.
Thanks,
as it comes up again tomorrow. Thank you. And that's it for now from Coote.
Thank you. Hugh Rimmington with that report.
And a reminder, 10 News will have special coverage of the memorial in Bali marking the 10th anniversary of the bombings. That's tomorrow morning at 11.